do some kind of a common agreements, and then you basically know if you generated a bit of information and someone else is using it to do X or Y, you know back what it's being used for, and then you can actually get rewards or get at least to know what it's been doing. So I would say that blockchain and Internet of Things would be really, really fundamental to build a real traceability of the data going into the data.
It's not directly answering your question, but it's a comment I wanted to do in general. Is that CAPS, it's a call for getting funding for projects. But it's actually more than that. It's a framework in which you can get to meet many other people who are working in your same areas in other countries, or people who are trying to put into practice a project like yours, and you can learn from them. And I am, and obviously I am very happy to be part of a project that has been funded, and the peer-to-peer banks has been a great occasion for learning to work in a multidisciplinary environment where there are many techies, there are a grassroots type of organization. It has been really the framework of a European project is something I have learned a lot. It was the first time I was applying, and we, and many of the partners part of the peer-to-peer value were the first time we were applying. We got in, that's rare. There is like a scale of learning how to do a European project that you're funding that is, you need to, you have to learn a lot. But it's really a great experience, a part of the money, you know, that you get funded for do what you want to do. It's a framework of work that is very stimulant, and not only the projects that I am encouraging you to get involved with the projects in the ways that sometimes there are open goals inside of the projects, like the case of Confine, or there are events in which the projects are presenting the results, or networking events like the one we are organizing on the 25th of February in the CCCB. Like, getting contact with the projects can be also a way to inject, and also considering that as part of CAPS there are also conferences. Like in July it's going to be the CAPS conference in which there would be the projects, but there would be also a very good representation of people doing interesting things on with the technology and with the community kind of aim. And I think if you have the possibility to inject with it, it's really a part of the element of funding. It's really a very good environment for learning and sharing. And there is, with CAPS, there is a very big, CAPS also it's a call that wants to renew on the type of people that get the European funding. So not to be the always like big partners or big actors that have been receiving funding for many, many years, but try to more into new kind of ideas and new type of partners. And that's something that there is a real opportunity there. I have a question to you. Is that someone has asked me to share the list of participants?
It was you.
Okay. So I want to ask you if there is someone who doesn't like that I share this list, and if other people also want to have it. Basically, this list is the list of people who have registered to the event. So during the launch, if you tell me you don't want to be part, I will take your email out and we'll make available the list to everyone.
I asked for the participants because I thought it was a way to see who is attending the meeting, and then we can have a more productive meetings during the afternoon. That's why, and also because I didn't join the afternoon list, you just show up and join the meeting. So that's the reason why I asked for the training.
And also the video will make available from the peer-to-peer value website, so if you know other people that didn't come but would like to see the presentation.
No, but the point is, because I want to, because I know this afternoon will be quite tight, and if I had the attending list before, I can join the organization that might be interesting to control and then we can approach them directly, instead of looking at the...
So now we have the lunch break, but in the afternoon there is an open space session. Please, Samuel, who is going to facilitate it, if you can introduce the methodology, so...
Yeah, the idea is that everyone that has an idea of a CAPS project already in mind, we would allow you to talk 2-3 minutes about it. And so we would see a series of ideas, okay? And afterwards we will have like an open space technologies call. The idea is that all the ideas that have been presented can have their own corner in the Fab Lab, and people can go there and talk and make a group to talk about the idea further. So you can have quality time in order to get in depth on the idea, right? So if you have an idea of a project, talk to me, or we will put here a blackboard right there.
Thank you, everyone.
Yeah.